Now, if you want to enjoy this, we've got to go back a few years. For the uninitiated, those were very popular tunes. They still are, actually.
Oh, yeah.
In the late 1990s and early 2000s by the Irish pop group Westlife.
Lead singer Shane Filan went on to forge a successful solo career and has released 3 albums to date. His latest, titled Love Always.
And look, we're thrilled to have him in studio with us. Shane.
Good morning, Shane.
How are you loving Singapore? The last time you were back was like 5 years ago.
Yeah, I was working out exactly. It's 4 years, 3 months ago, yeah. So it actually feels like a long time ago. But it's great to be back, back promoting the new album, obviously, as well. So it's cool.
So you said Love Always was an album that you've always wanted to make. Why?
It was just, I suppose, my first 2 albums were, I did a lot of kind of original material.
Yeah.
But, you know, I think making an album full of kind of famous love songs was something I wanted to do for a long time. And to get to sing them, you know, even like the Bonnie Raitt song or, you know, Bryan Adams' Heaven or Eternal Flame, there's just so many great songs on there. And it's nice to be able to sing them every now and then. And I got to do it on this album. So it was a lot of fun.
Did you get a lot of fans writing in to say, could you sing particular sort of ballads? Or did you actually reach out and say, all right, I'll do that for you?
Do you know what I did, actually? We did it for the first time ever. I put it out on my social media to say, which song would you like me to sing? So I got loads of suggestions, and some of them are crazy, some of them are good, but Eternal Flame from the Bangles was one of them. And straight away it kind of struck a chord with me because it was a song that I can remember being very young. One of the first songs I remember listening to or seeing on TV. So I said, you know, it's a girl's obviously version, so I'll do a version of it. It's just an acoustic version, but it turned out quite nice, so I'm really happy with it.
All right, Shane, I got to ask you this. Westlife happened about 20 years ago.
Yeah.
I was in my teens. I remember all the songs very clearly, all the sing-along with my girls at school. Does it seem really that long ago to you, or do you still feel like Westlife is very much a part of who you are?
Well, it's very much a part of who I am. I think Westlife is, you know, I think it's what one of the main reasons I'm here and one of the main reasons I'm still singing. A lot of fond memories for me, too. A lot of great songs over the years. But it is, yeah, it does feel like a long time ago. But I don't know, it's funny, like we started when I was like, what, 18, 19?
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, a great memories though. Oh, like we came to Singapore a lot.
Do you remember any of your boy band moves?
Boy band moves?
Oh, yeah.
The thing about Westlife is we didn't really move that much.
No, but you have that whole like,
we left that to the Backstreet
thing,
Boys.
Right? Oh, the Backstreet Boys, okay,
the Backstreet Boys did the dance
and NSYNC,
sang,
right?
And NSYNC.
Yeah,
so
yeah,
we sang the ballads and we liked to get up off our stools and stuff like that for the key change. And we were different.
Synchronized walking.
Synchronized walking,
good.
Which is
that's
actually
good,
very difficult.
I can imagine.
You gotta practice.
What's the best thing about being in a boy band and the worst thing about being a boy band?
Tell us.
The worst thing, who has to get up first in the morning is probably the worst, to get up first to go to hair and makeup or something like that.
Why?
You always used to have scissor, paper, rock and stuff to see.
Because everyone wants a bit of a sleep in.
Well, everybody wants to be last, so you might have an extra hour in bed.
See, I think
so in Asia, when you're out in Asia and you're jet lagged, that's a big deal. So that's probably the worst thing. The best thing was, you know what, we got to live our dream. You know, we got to travel the world and be pop stars, and that's all we wanted to be, the Backstreet Boys, when we were younger, and then we got to do our own version.
Did you prank each other quite a lot on tour?
No, we weren't too bad, actually, no. The boys didn't really prank me too much because I never liked it. I got really serious if they did something to me, which was kind of put me off. But we did it on stuff on stage and stuff loads of times. Mm-hmm. But we had a lot of fun.
Now, you've been a musician for so many years now, from being in a boy band to a solo artist. Now, what were some of your, say, top 2 career highlights of all time?
Career highlights? I think, you know, doing what we did, we got to travel the world so much and see so many places. We got to meet some amazing people. We got to meet the Pope in the Vatican, which was incredible.
And
we got to bring our mums and dads with us to meet the Pope. So for us, being Irish and all our mums like Catholic and stuff, that was a big deal. So they got to shake hands with the Pope. So, you know, we got to meet Barack Obama, President Obama. And
wow.
Probably meeting people, I'd say, and just seeing city, you know, coming to places and seeing amazing cities all over the world. We got to, I suppose, live the dream, as you say, and still
it
traveling,
like
still
it.
Going.
Well, the good thing is you're still touring and you plan to come back to Singapore sometime in March, maybe the whole of Southeast Asia, whole of Asia?
Yeah, that's it, yeah. So I'm starting in March, I come back and I play the Coliseum on the 10th of March. So that's just announced, I think tomorrow it's going on sale. And then I'm going to tour throughout Asia kind of for the rest of the year.
Mm-hmm.
So I have different gigs in Indonesia. I'm doing a few gigs there and hopefully do more. I'm going to KL tomorrow to start promoting the album there and onto Philippines and onto everywhere else as much as I can.
Nice.
I'm going to come back a lot. You're going to see me a lot.
It's good. Come back and see us every time you come back, yeah?
Thank you.
So any chances of, do you see, like, people your age, musicians in your genre, trying to make a comeback? Because we hear that, you know, Craig David's also trying to make a comeback. Do you think it's easy? Is it to be successful?
I think it's all about music. I think Craig David's made a really good comeback so far. But I think it's down to music for any band or any singer. I think it's still about having great music. I don't think bands can come back. They can come back and tour, and maybe that's it, you know, for a nostalgic reason. But I think if a band comes back, it needs to be amazing, because people have the memory of it being amazing before. So you're kind of setting yourself a bar that you got to reach straight away. Mm-hmm. But I think musicians, it always comes down to music, no matter who you are. You know, it's all about how good your songs are.
When you put out this latest album called Love Always, did you win a whole bunch of new fans? Did kids tell their parents about, look, you know, I know this new artist called Shane Filan, and they're going, gosh, we know this man.
Yeah, we know this guy from 20 years ago. there's a very mixed age group, which is great. You know, I see a lot more young people coming to my shows as well, which some of them are too young to kind of be a Westlife fan. Well, maybe their mums are, or whatever, their dads. Probably their mums are.
Probably the mums,
like Fool Again or songs like that. I get a good kind of age range at all my gigs. Sometimes I do meet and greets sometimes, and I meet a lot of, like, three. I meet, like, the daughter, the mother, and the grandmother.
Wow.
That's pretty impressive.
That's happening a lot lately, so I don't know if that's making me feel old or if I've been in the business too long. I don't know, but it's great to see it, because it obviously goes through the family, which is lovely.
And you said, you know, for a band to make a comeback, they have to be really amazing. The Spice Girls are supposed to be reuniting.
I heard that actually just as we came out here.
For you guys?
I don't know. You know, it's something that I get asked every day. I always get asked the Westlife question. Maybe someday it could happen, of course. You know, if it's something we all decide to do, you know, I'm sure it'd be a lot of fun if we did do it. But we'll have to wait and see, I suppose.
Get back into your synchronized walking moves again.
You know what? Yeah. That will take a lot of practice. we've been out of practice for a long time.
It's difficult.
Look, you've got three kids. It's hard to believe this, but you've got three kids. Do they offer any critiques at all whenever you sing and say, look, Dad, maybe you should just take it down a couple of notches or bring it up a couple?
They are my biggest critiques, definitely. It's funny, you know, they love listening to my music, but, you know, sometimes they want me to play the songs a lot, and I've been recording them for a while. Mm. They're like, Daddy, play that song. But they'll always pick their favorite off the album, or if it's not a good song, they'll tell me they don't really like it.
Yeah.
And it's funny, because kids kind of, you know, they don't really listen to much. They hear the melody straight away. They don't really think about lyrics or whatever. But yeah, they love coming to the shows and stuff, and they love Daddy's a singer, and they like to get to tour the world a bit.
Could we ever see you going into acting or maybe doing some rapping?
Do you know what? Rapping is something that I actually like listening to rap music when I'm in the gym.
Yeah.
I do. I love it. There's nothing like Eminem when you're on the treadmill. Acting, yeah. You know, Tom Cruise has called me recently about the new movie, but unfortunately, I was in Singapore, so I couldn't make it because of my Asian
priority,
tour.
Where your priority, yeah.
Absolutely. Nice. Who knows? Maybe in the future, you might see me in a Tom Cruise movie someday.
We look forward to it.
Yeah, why not?
Come back and see us again when you tour in March.
Yeah, thank you very much. Thank you for having me.
Thank you so much, Shane. That was delightful. We've been speaking with singer-songwriter Shane Filan.
I can tell you before we go, in the Super Bowl, New England Patriots 6, Philadelphia Eagles.